It was a Sunday night, and there weren't many people there. I was heartbroken and blue. The beer was flat, and I remember thinking, I should just go home. And then someone sat down beside me. She was older than me, easily in her 40s to my 20s. She was attractive, well-dressed, and looked like she also believed in being a clean gay. She said hello and introduced herself. Her name was Carolyn. A nice name. I knew immediately that she was going to try to pick me up. I could smell it like I could smell her New West perfume. And in my state, I was interested in letting anything improve my situation. I normally drank beer, but she bought me a Zima. We chatted, and when we got to a lull in what would have been normal conversation, she upped the game by lifting an eyebrow to mention how magnificent she was. She owned a business. Blah, blah, here's a Zima. She had a nice house in downtown. Blah, blah, Zima. She drove a fast car. Blah, blah, Zima. I was getting quite drunk. Or more specifically, she was getting me quite drunk on purpose. It was the implied arrangement here. And at some point, I think it was when we heard Winona for the second time, I started to feel uncomfortable. That little red warning light, the one that we all have, started its dull glow in the back of my head. But it was up in my head, so very far away from my pants, where I desperately wanted to feel the hot buzz of homo sex once again. So when she offered to take me in her amazing car to her amazing house, I slurred, sure. I don't remember what kind of car she drove. I bet it was red. I do remember her house. It was mid-century modern and clean, and all of its expensive surfaces were very shiny. She poured me a drink, took me by the hand, and led me back into her bedroom. It was quiet except for the low hum of an enormous saltwater aquarium. I thought she might put some music on, but instead she ushered me directly to her bed. There was immediate kissing, which led to groping and humping. The red warning light was glowing pretty brightly by now, and I wasn't enjoying myself as much as I thought I would, thanks to 23 Zimas, a glass of whiskey, and a complete lapse in judgment. But I forged on, bolstered by the promise of cookies and bloopers, of camping and poetry and women's music festivals, that were going to make sleeping with women so much lovelier than sleeping with men. I took her clothes off, and I was laying on top of her, doing all the things I thought I should do, going slowly as I had with Jessica. Minutes in, while I was still navigating her skin with a gentle mouth, before I even moved my hand anywhere near her end zone, she gave me a stern command. She said, "Put two fingers inside of me." Initially, it stopped me, this command. Though I was a fairly new lesbian and hadn't gotten that far in the instruction manual yet, I understood that two fingers is a fairly standard move, and I had gotten there soon enough. I guess she was just so obviously turned on by my awesome initial moves that she could not wait. So though there was nothing sweet about how this was happening, I put two fingers where I reckoned they should go, into her wetness, and started drunken sex. I began to get seriously turned on, because that's what happens when I find my way into a vagina. I was breathing heavily, sweating, watching her through my dilated pupils, feeling that wonderful, heavy, beating warmth in my own pants. I was getting into it, thoroughly enjoying myself when she spoke again. "Put three fingers inside of me." For the record, two was all I'd ever done. But Carolyn was older. Maybe when you get older, you need three. Thank you. on fire with delight. She spoke a third time. Put another finger in the ring. She commanded. Wait now. Even while drunk, I knew that made four. And four is too many. Four is a hand. Four is something you have a conversation about first, isn't it? Four was a chapter I hadn't expected to find in the manual. Four is when my pants went cold and the red light in my head went on so brightly that it made my scalp burn. I was being commanded sternly to do something that made me uncomfortable, something I didn't really want to do, something that didn't seem lovely at all. But I scrunched my four fingers tightly together, and four is what I did, because I agreed to all this, didn't I? I let her buy me drinks. I came here in her car, and I got into her bed. And now I had my hand inside her, and I hoped it would all be over soon, because I was getting pretty creeped out. And also because my arm was about to fall off. And then she said it.